Hello everyone, this is Harshali, working as an assistant professor with Anviva Institute. I'm here to share some basic points which will be useful while getting into an IT firms. Through this presentation, we'll see what are the basic points that we are going to cover. Let's begin the presentation. We'll cover today what is internet, what is World Wide Web, from where does internet and World Wide Web exist, transmission across the internet, few terms related to the internet, for example TCP/IP, domain names, certain services such as FTP, what do you mean by URL, and what is intranet and extranet. The basic question which always arises within us is whether internet and World Wide Web are they same or different. If they are different, then what it is? Basically, internet is nothing but it allows the different computers around the world to talk with one another. Whereas, when we are concerned with World Wide Web, it is a system of web pages and sites that uses internet to pass the file across. Basically, we can consider it is a service which has been used by internet. So, they are completely different. The next part is what is internet. Internet comprises of two words. One is your inter, another one is the net. Internet stands for your interconnected and the next part is your network. Interconnect is nothing but you when you connect two or more devices or certain system. Whereas network, it is considered as group of devices under one unit which might be sharing certain resources. So this is what internet. Now let's move to the history or the existence of your internet. Internet was originally used to allow the users of research computers at one university to be able to talk to the research computers at the another universities. The first ARPANET was designed. It is nothing but Advanced Research Project Agency Network. It is the first network that has been implemented the TCP/IP suite. This is a network that will continue to function even if the parts of it were destroyed in event of military attack or other disaster. In 1965, the first long distance communication took place between the computers situated in MIT and California. Later on in 1969, four computers client were connected together via ARPANET. ARPANET, as we have discussed earlier, using TCP/IP suite, it is basically used for what? Packet switching. Over here, the data is been sent across the network and it has been routed in terms of packets. How do we use the internet? These are the few services using which we use the internet. To share the files, we use emails. To browse your data, we use hypertext browsers. To share your files, we use FTP service. We use mobile internet. We use instant messaging, gaming, learning, video conferencing, and so on. So these are the few terms where we regularly use our internet. Next, the graph shows the growth of users who are using internet in worldwide. Okay, the graph shows from 1995 till 2010. Next, the basic common terms we should be knowing is what browsers. Browser is nothing but it is an application where we interact with the information on World Wide Web. It is basically an application where we retrieve, present and traverse our information using certain resources. That resources might be your web pages, images, video and other multimedia content. These are few basic browsers which are been listed. For example, Opera, IE, Firefox, UC browser, Safari, Chrome. The graph shows the market ratio, the users which are been using the particular browser. The most commonly used browser is your Chrome. Next concept we are moving, that is transmission. How transmission is done across the internet means how actually computers share the resources or share the files from one end to the another. So computers are connected together via one network, or you can say a transmission line. The main objective of ARPANET project was to investigate the development of decentralized computer network. The network then became and known as what you are internet, means a group of networks they have formed an internet. So as we have discussed earlier, ARPANET was the first network which was using your TCP/IP protocol suite. And what is actually this TCP/IP protocol suite? It is an architecture where there are five layers, and at each particular layer it functions the packet. Let's move on to your IP suite, that is your internet protocol suite. Now it includes the number of standard protocols. So basically there are two standard, one is your TCP, that is transmission control protocol, and another one is your internet protocol. Now in transmission control protocol, it is connection oriented, whereas IP is a protocol which is connectionless. Whenever you want to route certain information from one end to another end, it should pass through this TCP/IP suite. So TCP/IP basically defines how electronic devices or computers should be connected to the internet, means the physical medium, whether it is Ethernet, etc., or how data should be transmitted between them, between these layers, how data is been transmitted. So let's move further. The first part we will see, that is your TCP, transmission control protocol. Basically it is used for communication between two different applications. As you can see, it is using fixed connection, that is nothing but it is connection oriented. That means before sending the data to the another end, you need to synchronize with the other end. If you want to do the communication, first you need to send and request whether the server or whether the other end is available to communicate. If the line is open, then acknowledgement is sent back to the receiver. After that, whatever messages you want to send, you will be sending requests, and from the other end you will be getting the response. The third part is to terminate. Now it depends upon receiver and sender to end the connection. So that concept is known as your three-way handshaking. So handshaking is done between the applications. A communication line opens and then you can send request and response. Other part is your IP. Again, it is used to handle the communication between the computers. Once again, TCP is used for your application, whereas IP is your source and destination. Your IP is your connectionless protocol. Whatever messages need to be sent to the another end are broken down into small independent chunks. The chunks are known as packets. These packets are being routed by using the routing protocols. They might arrive at the destination unordered. Now it is depending upon the receiver to rearrange that packets and assemble the message. IP is only in concern whether my packet are being delivered to my destination or not. TCP/IP is TCP and IP working together, means there are certain communication where we require both TCP as well as IP. So they are used in hand and hand, which is consisting of five layers: application layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. physical layer is taking care of what is the transmission media. As we have discussed, that transmission is nothing but what is the transmission media and how data is being transferred. So physical layer is concerning how my streams, means your message has been broken down into stream, whereas in data link layer, your packets which are being available in network and transport layer, that are being converted to the frames. Network layer takes care of routing your packets from source to destination. Transport layer, again the packets are being routed, but from particular application to application. Whereas application layer is concerned how your data is being accessed using different services. So that is what we have discussed about TCP/IP. The next common basic term which comes is your IP addresses. Now, when you are working with an internet or world wide web, how your system is going to be identified? So every system is given one particular IP address. So using this IP address, you can uniquely identify your system on the internet or on a network. Okay, so the IP address, there are four numbers. Your IP address is divided into your four octaves. That four octaves range, every number, that every octet range from between 0 to 255. The entire this four octaves comprises of 32 bits. That is nothing, your 32 bits are your four bytes. Now, you can see over here the example. These are your four octaves, 127. So the number might be ranging from 0 to 255, second octet, third octet, and first octet. Now, this IP address is broken down into two parts. One is your network ID and another one is your host ID. We'll see later on, depending upon the classes type, the octet defines network ID and remaining defines your host ID. Basically, your IP address has been presented into four octets separated by your period. These are your different classes. Basically, there are five classes or IP addresses: A, B, C, and D. Your class A is ranging from IP address 1 to 126. Now, 1 to 126 is the first block. Now, over here, the first octet is defining your network and remaining is your host. So whenever you're using class A, it will be used for your huge networks, where there are huge organizations where you have lots of clients. Over there, you will be using class A. Now, 127 number, or you can say IP address, is been reserved. It is used for your local host, that is 127.0.0.1. It is used as your loopback address. Then your class B starts from 128 to 191. This is your class B. The two octets are used for your networks and remaining two are acting as your host ID. So wherever there is your small organization, okay, we'll use this one. The most commonly used class is your class C. This is what, 192 to 223, where your only one is your network and remaining all are what, your host. Class D, it is basically used for your multicast, where it starts from 224 to 254, and class E, it is reserved for your future use. These are everything about your IP addresses. Next, what is domain name? As we have discussed, that every system, every computer has its own unique IP address which has been identifying on their network. It is not possible to remember all the IP addresses, all the 12 digits. So the alternate way or the alternative is given is, we'll be converting your IP address to a particular name. For example, we can't remember the IP address of Yahoo, Google, Facebook, Twitter, XYZ. But what we are doing on URL, we are just typing www.google.com. So google.com is nothing but the domain name which has been representing a particular IP address. So that is what, to identify a computer or an IP network by using a logical or a domain name. Now again, this domain name is been divided into certain parts. So that we'll see over here. This is your uniform resource locator, that is your URL. Okay, so the name that corresponds to IP address in DNS, this is your domain name system or domain name server, which is responsible for converting your IP address to domain name. Okay, it's known as what, your URL. Now can you see, this is your entire one URL, okay, which has been divided, which has been representing a particular part. So HTTP is nothing but the scheme, means the protocol which you are using. Since you are browsing, you are accessing the data, you are surfing it, so we are using which type of protocol? So we are using HTTP. So this is the scheme. Then it has been preceded by your host. So my host is SCSS, then my domain. So this is my domain. TCD represents my domain. From this particular host network, I'm searching for this particular zone, and IE represents your country code. Now every country has its one particular code, or you can say this code depends upon the organization, whether you are using commercial, government and so on. Colon, it has been represented by one particular port number. On which port, means whether if you are using application to application, then you will be having this port number. Path, which file you want to access, and the file name. So your URL consists of this many categories. Okay, so that is the scheme: host, domain, country code, port, path and your file name. Over here, these are certain URL codes. For example, IE is used for your Irish websites. Similarly, .com, whenever you are using any commercial institute or service provider, you will be using .com. For if your website is related to educational, you will be using edu. If it is government website, it will be ending with .gov. Okay, then if it is network service provider, you will be using .net. If it is used for US military purpose, then it is .mil. So these are different country codes, as well as you can say URL codes. Now okay, next basic concept is your HTTP. This is your scheme, hypertext transfer protocol. This is a protocol or set of rules which are needs to be used while communicating between the web server and a web browser. Basically, HTTP is used for sending the request from the web client to your web server and returning a web content from the server back to the client. Basically, what we are doing, we are requesting for a particular page from the client to the server, and from the another end we get one web page written as your response. Now, before the web, the IP was using FTP, means before using this www, okay, instead of using HTTP protocol, we were using file transfer protocol. But since there were certain limitations, it was slow, hence we have invented hypertext transfer protocol. Now what HTTP is doing, basically it has adopted the concept of hypertext links, but it is a protocol which includes certain methods. Now there are four certain methods, as we have discussed in TCP. It is three-way handshaking. First, we need to use connection. We need to establish the connection between the client and server, whether the service which we are requesting, or we are requesting for a particular server, whether it is ready to listen my request or whether it is ready to open that line. So first method which I need to call is what, connection. Once the acknowledgement comes from the server, we'll continue with our request. We'll ask for a particular resource or whatever the query. After sending the request from the server, if the line is open and is ready to listen, he will send an acknowledgement, means whatever web page we have requested will get an output as a web page. And the last method which is used, that is what the close. We need to terminate our connection which we have been established using connection method. So these are the four methods which are been used using what? HTTP. This is common scenario of your client and server computing, what we have discussed in previous slide. Service consumer will be using your service client, he will be sending the request that has been received on the another end server, he will offer it, then response will be given back again to your service client. Next we are going to see important part, that is the port number. One is your IP address. Whenever it comes with source and destination, we'll be communicating with IP address. Whenever you want to communicate with application to application, okay, then we'll be communicating using port numbers. So port numbers is used to distinguish between the individual networking application that are running simultaneously above your IP, TCP/IP suite. Okay, so port numbers are divided into two parts: well-known port numbers and ephemeral port numbers. The port numbers ranging from 0 to 1024, they are known as well-known port numbers. So for example, port number 80, it has been reserved for HTTP. 194, it is reserved for your internet relay chat, that is whenever you do video conferencing and all, for that purpose we use 194. If you are transferring a particular file, that is your FTP protocol, we use port number 21. Whenever you are sending an email, the protocol which you use is your simple mail transfer protocol, so the port number used is 25. Whenever you are accessing certain resource remotely, then you are using telnet protocol, so it has been using port number 23. So these are some ports which are being reserved. So the port numbers ranging from 0 to 1024, they are known as well-known ports. Apart from this, the value ranging from above 1024, you can use any port number for any service, so they are known as your ephemeral port. The last concept, this is what is intranet and extranet. Now, internet is something we have discussed. Internet is nothing but different computers around the world that are used to talk with one another. Then what is intranet actually? Now, intranet is just a secure network that is contained within an organization. Internet is worldwide, whole throughout networks of network. Whereas intranet, it has been restricted towards a particular area. So it is within an organization. So you can say it uses certain firewall for maintaining certain security. Okay. Whereas on the another end, extranet, it is a secure network that allows outsider to use your intranet with the permission, means the minor area is being used by the another outer area. So that concept is known as what you are extranet. So over here we have discussed about what is internet, what is World Wide Web, we have seen certain concept of TCP, we have seen HTTP, FTP, URL, what are port numbers, what are IP addresses. I hope this video have explained you the all basic concepts which are been required to be known if you are getting into your IT firm. I hope this video was very useful for you people. If you have any queries, drop the query below. And to know the next update about the presentation, please subscribe my video. Thank you.